Listen, Chris, this is important to me. If I back down now, then that lying bastard's won. And I'm not going to let that happen.
Well, well, what do you know? You lying bitch! You've been dealing with this mongrel all along.
I didn't want to be, she made...
Oh, shut up! Well, yeah, I traded, so what? It's all a matter of supply and demand. They demanded, I supplied.
Oh, my God. Let go, Jude. I'll leave it alone. What the hell do you think you're doing? Now, you better have an explanation, girl, and make it fast.
Sit down.
Oh, I know I've got to push.
I can hardly blame him. I've never had anything to do with running a home.
Well, probably do him good. What do you reckon, Beige? Her husband...
Not now. I've got other important things on our mind.
Not for me.
For all of us. Like you lot backing Mackenzie's insurance racket, for instance.
Faye said it was hers.
Yeah, well, you were new here. You wouldn't know. Faye's okay, but you can't believe a word she says.
Oh, there you go, Beige.
Well, I don't know what you're fussing about.
Yeah, we've been doing all right out of it.
So has the one who killed Paddy. Oh, fair go, B. You know how we all felt about poor Paddy Copping.
Then why deal with her?
Because we thought it was Faye.
Well, now you know better. Now you know she's Mackenzie's pimp.
I couldn't help it,
B. Oh, bull. Faye's right, B. You couldn't expect her to cross Nola when she has to share a dorm with her. Now, could you, B?
Yeah, well, what's it matter anyway? I mean, all we bought was a few smokes and stuff. And you've got to admit, insurance is the best deal we've ever had.
Where do you think those payouts come from?
Well, I'm in front.
Is that all you care about?
It's not doing any harm, is it?
Yeah, well, we'll see. We'll see how you feel when the freak takes over. How's she going to find out, babe? Use your head. She knows we've had time to lay her money since the fire, and she won't wait much longer to take her cut.
Go on, Jude. Give him a cuddle. He won't bite. Oh, he's a beautiful little nipper, isn't he? I mean, don't get me wrong, Hazel. I like babies just as much as the next bloke.
Well, that's great, Jude, because it'll be really good practice for your new grandson.
Oh, no, you don't. This baby cannot stay here.
But we could look after him.
Sure we can.
But we can't do that. He belongs to someone. We've got to ring the police.
The cops? Oh, but why? At least he gets some love from us.
Hazel, I know that. And I know how well you'd look after him. But we don't know the facts. I mean, what if his mother's ill? What if he's kidnapped?
Oh, we'd have heard.
There could be 100 different reasons. Supposing his mother's just some young teenage kid scared. Anything.
Can't we look after him till you find out?
The police would never let us do that, and you know it.
Well, don't tell them.
Oh, Hazel, for God's sake, think a minute. I mean, look at this place. You know what the women are trying to do here? Do you really think that's what's best for the baby?
Oh, okay. I'll call the bloody cops then.
She's right, Haze.
I'd have loved the little bloke. I really would have.
Yeah, good.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Morris.
Oh, hello, Mr. Young.
Is that Janice Young's husband?
Mm.
I thought he might be one of your regular lunch dates.
Oh, I'll bet you did.
Ah, 2 gin and tonics, thanks.
Thank you.
Now, about moving in. You made up your mind? Oh, yes, I have thought about it, but what if I can't find anywhere else? You're only going to be stuck with me.
Well, I'll take that risk. Besides, I don't think it'll be that permanent.
Well, you've got more faith than I have.
Rubbish. I think you'll go back to him. You can't throw 16 years out the window just like that.
No, if you say so. Now, come on. You're not going to preach, are you? Otherwise, I'll call your boyfriend over. I'll get them. Thanks.
Well, that's all I need. Now the baby.
Yeah, move Hazel along, will you, Michelle?
Okay.
A lot of the women have become attached to the little bloke. Can't say I blame them.
Well, they needn't worry. He'll be well looked after.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Hey, Hayes, they're waiting for you.
All right, I'm coming.
What happens now?
At his age, I stay in hospital while we look for the mother.
What are your chances of finding her?
Fair. Sometimes the mother changes her mind, but she gets scared of prosecution or publicity. Others end up in hospital with complications.
She ought to be shot. What sort of a woman dumps a beautiful little kid?
Usually they're very young and very frightened.
Yeah, that's right. I can remember with Laurie, I was scared stiff.
That's different.
Not really.
Well, what happens if you don't find the mother?
It's not like lost property. You don't get him back, if that's what you mean.
What then?
Oh, there are lots of childless couples out there waiting for someone like this. He won't miss out.
But you miss out on me. Well, you don't.
Thank you very much. No, no more.
Enjoyed that. Mind you, I think I wasted time. I could have been at home packing.
Now, stop worrying and relax. I'll help you tonight.
It's all right. There's not that much anyway. I have to talk to the kids sometime, though.
Yes, I don't envy you that.
No, I've already tried to explain, at least to Jennifer. But it's hard for them.
Sure I can't help?
No, it's something I have to do for myself. Oh, don't look now, but here he comes.
Excuse me, Mrs. Morris. Don't want to butt in, but I'm a bit worried about Janice. Stuck in that place with all those... Well, you know what I mean.
Well, there's no need to. Oh, I'm sorry, this is Deputy Governor Palm.
Oh, hello. I'm not asking for any special favours or anything like that, you understand?
Of course not.
It's just that, well... I mean, she's not really the criminal type. The only reason she's in there is because she stood up for her rights. I suppose you could say she's a bit stubborn for her own good, that's all.
I take it you don't agree with her?
Oh, I don't know. I suppose I just wouldn't have let it go that far, that's all.
Well, I'm sure she'll be all right. It's our job to keep an eye on her.
No favours, though.
Oh, no, no. No, thanks very much. Look, that's all I was asking. Look, if there's anything I can do for you ladies, I hope you'll let me know any time.
Thank you, but really, there's no need.
Oh, I didn't mean it like that. Hell. It's just as well I'm a carpenter and not a politician, isn't it? Now, what I meant was that if you ever...
I know what you mean. Thanks. I'll keep it in mind.
Yeah. Thanks.
Bye. I've heard of the barter system, but that's ridiculous. Coffee?
Right. Thanks,
chocolate.
Mrs.
Don't thank me. Those things could be more trouble than they're worth. Just be careful, that's all.
I don't understand.
Well, you didn't lose buy-up, but the other women did. So, you've now got things that they want. And what they want, they usually get. I don't think I can make it plainer than that.
You mean they'll attack us for these things?
They'd attack you for a lot less than that. If there is trouble, there's always an officer around somewhere.
I'll remember that, thanks.
Wait at the gate. I had my way. None of them would be getting by up. We're only creating trouble for ourselves.
Thought you must like this place. You're always in here.
Oh, give it a rest, will you? Didn't have much choice. That's why I gave you a bell to come in.
Yeah, well, next time you do that, speak English, will you? I didn't understand half the things you were saying.
But don't be stupid, Roxy. I couldn't well tell you everything with them listening in, could I?
Oh.
You know, it worries me. You're supposed to be one of me smarter mates. So, did you bring it?
What? Oh, yeah, the cash.
Not now. We're supposed to do it when she's not looking.
Yeah, all right. Hey, what's this for anyway? I really can't afford it, you know.
Well, you see, we've got this cute little scheme going. Everyone kicks in for insurance, and then when we get into strife with the screws, we cop a payoff.
Struth, you're kidding.
No, double your money in no time.
Don't go wandering off, Daniels. Your time's nearly up.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Hey, no, Shelley's doing 3 months in Barnhurst. I think I'll wisen her up on it.
Shelley? Yeah, she's got the house to clean up real good.
Right, stick us a date.
Righto, Daniels, that's it.
street have been seen.
Come on, get moving. Your time's up.
Hey?